Okay, so we're at the top of the pitch of climbing, and there's a lot of loose rock around. So this is another typical scenario that you might encounter in the mountains. But here we're in a multi-pitch destination. We've encountered the same thing. So there's a few different ways that you can deal with this. If there's just a ledge on top that has loose rock, a lot of times you can just get a big bite of the rope, snake it down past the loose rock, and then when you throw the rest of the rope, you make sure it goes clear of that ledge. That's dealing with one small ledge. But if you're dealing with broken terrain and a series of steps, then that technique often won't work well because your rope is simply going to land on more loose rock and increase the likelihood of causing rockfall on other people. So we need to come up with another tool. So in this case, in an alpine environment, it's common we have packs that are large enough to accommodate some portion of the rope. If they can accommodate half of the rope, that's ideal. And that's pretty easy to do if you're working with alpine ropes that are typically 60 meters or less and oftentimes small in diameter. So you're only dealing with actually 30 meters of rope in the pack at a time. So let's take a look at what I'm gonna do here. So first, just as always, you wanna make sure to close the system. So I'm gonna put a barrel knot in the end of each of my ropes, okay, or each end of this single rope. Okay. There we go. And now I'm gonna just treat this rope as one. Okay, so the rope is already nicely stacked from me setting up the rappel. It's gonna clip through a higher point, okay, in this case using a sling, and I'm just gonna push it into the pack, okay? Just looking to get half of this rope in. Okay, so I'm estimating, because the true middle of the rope is of course through my anchor. I've isolated it by putting in a BHK. All right, that way my rope isn't gonna move from the middle. So that's plenty. Okay, yeah, push it down. Okay, and then I'm just gonna cinch that up. Harness, if there's anything that I don't need, it's good to make sure that's, you know, high and tight, some people will say. Okay, so nothing's dangling, or I could have put it in my backpack prior to stuffing the rope, which was what I did with the majority of the gear that was on my harness from prior. I like to have a few items out just for problem solving, just in case. Okay, so I'm doing the same thing with this guy. Identify which shoulder I want this to go over. I'm right-handed, so I like this to go over my right shoulder. Rockfall, third hand, very essential, okay? If we think that's a problem for us down here, then as my rope is moving and I'm rappelling, I can generate rockfall myself. So really important to put that third hand on. Okay, so at this point, ordinarily, I would take myself off like so. This anchor, but right now my cameraman's attached to this anchor, so I'm gonna leave that anchor in place. Okay, so I'm all set up. I checked my system, looks good. That's the middle, got a good amount of rope down there. That looks pretty good. Okay, open this up now. And now, with the remainder of this rope here, I'm gonna make sure that clears this initial ledge. It's gonna leave a little bit of a loop. I'm also dealing with a little bit of wind, so this is also a great technique to use when you have a lot of wind. I prefer backpacking as opposed to doing the saddlebags. Saddlebags oftentimes with loose rock around can cause rockfall too. As they start to get disorganized, they can start to dangle down. So saddlebags, similarly, it's a better idea to just do half the rope so you don't have as much that can result in tangles.